It's hard to imagine a species more at risk of extinction. It's got to be one of the rarest, one of the most endangered fish species in Australia and the world. They're small and cryptic, of course, and they're hard to find physically, but probably the bigger reason they're hard to find is because they're sociable, so they like to be in a small patch of reef. All the individuals in a very small population are close to each other, so you need to know that 50 metre patch of reef to be looking in the first place. Most marine scientists in Tassie certainly know about the spotted handfish. You know, I think it's right here at our doorstep, so most of us had sort of, out of curiosity, have dived and found spotted handfish early in the piece of living in Tassie. The reds more interested me because I had heard that they had actually disappeared. We had a hot tip of another sighting. When you hear that, you take it with a grain of salt because they're recognisable, but we had no real idea whether it was a real sighting or not. We didn't really know what to expect. But we did have some coordinates just from somebody who had put a point on Google Earth and said, you know, that's third hand, that's where it was. So when we checked out that spot and habitat didn't look quite right, we were a little bit sceptical. Searched a little bit further afield, found some beautiful habitat, but no signs of fish. And so we were all expecting it was probably just an unreliable sighting, or perhaps just an individual that had strayed from the other population. Certainly when we found one after a long search and then suddenly found a whole bunch more, you know, it was pretty clear it was a separate, nice little patch of them. And we started monitoring that population with reef life survey transects. They're actually quite variable in appearance. They can change their colour intensity quite a bit, but their spots tend to stay pretty consistent. There's actually so few that have been observed and photographed over the years, it's pretty easy to see when one turns up, you know it's one of the ones that you've seen before or not. And it only takes a quick flick back through the photos to work out that it is or it isn't. The current situation at the key population with the habitat at risk of urchins basically taking down the seaweed, that area really needs restoring a natural balance there through protection from fishing of lobsters and of other large fishes and predators that might take down urchins is an important step in the long run. There's actually quite a lot that could be done.